This video is about the own notation. Assume we have designed two algorithms, red and blue, for the same problem. Now we would like to know which one is faster. But how can we measure the speed of an algorithm? For this, we use the notion of time complexity. The time complexity of an algorithm is the number of basic arithmetic operations performed by the algorithm with respect to the size n of the given input. For example, performing a comparison, an addition, or accessing an element from memory counts as a single operation each. The input size n often denotes the number of items in the input. For example, the following algorithm takes a list of n numbers. Then for each of the n numbers, we access it from memory and add it to the sum. This can be done using two unit operations. Therefore, the overall time complexity of the algorithm is 2n. Let's go back to our original algorithms. We want to measure the time complexity as a function of the input size. For a given input size, we can plot the time complexity of both algorithms. We see that algorithm blue is performing better than red because its time complexity is lower. However, what happens when we further increase the input size? Now it is algorithm red that performs better. We are usually interested in the asymptotic time complexity of an algorithm. Meaning, we want to compare the time complexity as the input size goes to infinity. Exactly for this purpose, we have the own notation. Formally, the own notation denotes the set of functions that grow at most as fast as f. Mathematically speaking, for a function g, the fraction g over f does not go to infinity if g is in O of f. Let us look at a specific example. Can you figure out the own notation of the following function f? Let's try to simplify the terms of f. In the own notation, multiplicative constants do not matter for the asymptotic behavior, so we can get rid of them. Then, we only need to focus on the dominating term. Therefore, we can get rid of the logarithmic and linear expressions. Finally, we end up with the quadratic term. Therefore, the function f is in O of n squared. Many algorithms fall into one of the following asymptotic time complexities: constant, logarithmic, linear, polynomial, or exponential. For example, comparing two numbers is constant. Going through an array of n numbers to find the maximum is linear. And going through all possible binary strings of length n is exponential. This concludes our introduction of the own notation. Thank you for watching this video.